Hey YouTubers, DCollector777 here with my latest haul video. This video consists of the pickups I have made for the past week in terms of garage sales, thrift stores, Craigslist pickups, as well as a rare eBay purchase. So what I'm going to do is start off with this pickup. This might send a few of you back to your childhood. I picked this up for $2 at a garage sale, and it is the Robbie Jr. from Radio Shack. I've always wanted one of these back in the day, but they're just too damn expensive. This is the smaller version. It's the Jr., but it works great. As you can see, it does come with its remote and its tray. So I thought that was a pretty good pickup for $2. I got this book for free at a yard sale. I was asking if they had any video game items, and the guy said he didn't have any video games, but he did have this book, Mega Man NT Warrior. Just gave it to me for free. I thought that was super nice. Comic book read. And in terms of comic books, I did pick up a few at a yard sale. The guy told me that he wanted $1 for anything that was number one, and all the non-number ones he wanted 50 cents for. So that gives you a rough estimate of what I paid for these guys. Some of them are old school, pretty old school. Just gonna go ahead and start off with, I think I accidentally stuck this in the stack because I have no idea why I picked it up, but again, I believe that this was probably for $1. Kitty Pryde and Wolverine number 5, as well as number 3, and there are actually two more in between them. We got number 6 and number 4. It's a pretty cool cover. Those were, I believe, 50 cents each. I did pick up number 1 as well as number 2. We also got, I did pick up a few number ones. Secret Wars 2, number 1. This was $1. Got Black Panther number 1, in the limited series. It's a shame that this didn't come bag and board, but it's okay. I got a few to stick them in. We got Uncanny X-Men number 168. This one came bag and boarded, 50 cents. And for $1, got X-Factor number 1. Really happy to add this to my collection. Surprised that I didn't have it. And on the flip side, there's number 2. I kept on digging to see if there are any other goodies in X-Factor, like First Apocalypse. But unfortunately, there wasn't. And last but not least, this wasn't a number 1, so I paid 50 cents for it. And that is Marvel, from the Marvel Comics group, Amazing Adventures featuring Beast. It sucks how there's that white thing on his face, but as many of you guys know, this is the first appearance of the Furry Beast, number 11. So I did not have this book. This is going to go into a Mylar, but for 50 cents, there's no way I was going to leave this bad boy behind. So there's that for the comic books. Now, I believe I can show this. hear from the background. I got this for $5, I believe. It does have the minifigs in there. It's old school Lego set 6455. You could tell it's the vintage style because all the minifigs are yellow. Not like today how they're trying to get them skin tone. So I thought that was a great find at a yard sale. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and break off into a little clip at Goodwill. As you guys saw, I managed to score for $5 a green Nintendo 64 in-box, complete in-box controller. There you go. There is their dreaded new barcode sticker. It's a pain in the butt to take off, but I'm still very happy to pick this guy up. And also, yeah, this one's a bit pricey, but with all the minifigs in here, I thought it was worth it. Yeah, this was for $15, this huge bag of Legos, and as you can see, there's those guys. I think that is Obi-Wan right there. A few Stormtroopers. Yeah, there's a lot of goodies. I haven't actually ripped this bad boy open to see how many minifigs are in here, but I thought $15 was a great price. Now, on to another Goodwill clip that I'm going to go ahead and sneak in here. And as you guys saw, there was a Nintendo 64 system that I picked up. That was marked at $15. I'm not going to show it because a lot you guys all know what that looks like already. But the other item that is marked for $15 that I'm happy to add to my collection, but that is the PS1 combo complete in box. There you go. So happy to add that. Now, in terms of Craigslist purchases, I met up with the guy who was selling this for $15, but I got it down to $10, which I thought was a fair price. I mean, they go for about $15 plus shipping, you know, online. But it is for the GameCube, Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles, which I did not have. Disc is in great condition, complete, it does have the manual. And another awesome Craigslist pickup. Another guy had this priced at $60, but I got him down to $50 because I told him that the jumper was missing and I did not have this color. And that is the great purple Nintendo 64 with matching controller. So, also has the expansion pack, which is always a bonus. We agreed on $50, but when I got it, I asked, before we met up, I asked him if the port cover under was there, and he said it was, but when I looked at it, it was missing, so he dropped it down to $40. So, $40 for a working, great purple Nintendo 64 is a bargain. So I'm happy to add this. All I need is one more. I just need the smoke gray version, and I have all the fantastic Nintendo 64 colors. Hit up another garage sale. paid $1 a piece for these guys, which I thought was a great deal. First, it's a game for the PSP, Midway Arcade Treasures. Did not have this one. It says mark $2, but she said everything on the table with DVDs and stuff like that was $1. So got that for PS2. Art the Lad. I may have this one already. I still have to check. For PlayStation 2, for the longest time I couldn't find this game. Now I am finding them more and more. The Warriors Complete. And for Xbox 360, Alone in the Dark. And also a Game Boy Advance Color that I have never come across in the wild, but I dug and dug in the bins that she had, and I found the pink Game Boy Advance for $1. Awesome price. So there's that. Now, hit up another garage sale. Asked if he had any old school games. He told me he had a Super Nintendo that he was willing to part with. So for $10, I got the system. A little bit yellowed, but works great. One controller and the power and AV cables, which I'm not going to show because you guys already know what that looks like. He also threw in this for the Xbox, original Xbox Sphinx and the Cursed Mummy. And two Super Nintendo games. We got Toy Story and Mortal Kombat, all for $10, which I felt was a great deal. Went to another garage sale, saw this on the table, picked it up for $2. Game Boy Advance Spyro Super Pack, which I did not have. Let's see. Another pickup at a thrift store, non-Goodwill, for $1.99, The Sims for GameCube. You know, GameCube games are getting more and more popular again. So there's that. Now, let me go ahead and break off with a garage sale clip. Show you with you guys real quick. YouTubers, DCollector777 here. Just got out of this garage sale. And they didn't have any games out, but I asked if they had anything they wanted to sell. And they brought this out for me, asked for a total of $15. Yep, not a bad score. Alrighty guys, see you at the haul vid. Alright, as you guys saw, that was an awesome score in my opinion. I gotta make sure to keep my game face on when I'm dealing with people because, yeah, I wanted them to hand it to me. Maybe in fear of somebody coming behind me and, outbidding me. Even though we were making the deal already, it's happened to me before and, yeah, it's really annoying. So, for $15, I was able to get these four games in great condition. Beautiful condition. We got Black Label for PlayStation, Final Fantasy VIII. All complete. The discs are all flawless. That one. Also got Final Fantasy IX, which I did not have. Black Label complete in immaculate condition discs as well. So super stoked when he brought this one out as well. It's for the GameCube, Legend of Zelda, The Wind Waker. I found one of these bad boys before at a yard sale for $1, but it turns out that the disc was missing, so I still picked up the case. This one is in great condition, complete as well. And not only that Zelda game, but he also brought out this game, which I was so happy to see as well. It's the Ocarina of Time and also the Master Quest Special Edition. So yeah, $15 for all four of those. Thought it was a great price. I was just so happy that he brought them out for me. And last but not least, my eBay purchase. You know, some of these games I do trade in and try to flip all the ones that are duplicates so that I could build my own collection. So I went ahead and beefed up my Super Nintendo collection again and picked up Chrono Trigger. I mean, it's not in the best shape, but it's good enough for me. Very pricey game, and I'm super happy to add it to my collection. So there you have it, folks. Another fun-filled haul the past week. And as always, happy hunting, and thank you so much for watching.